Today, our topic of discussion is gene interaction. In gene interaction, mainly we will be dealing with different type of genes which will be regulating our different activities. Okay. So, first of all, we will deal with the definition. What does gene interaction means? Gene interaction occurs when two or more different genes influence the outcome of a single trait. That means when a single gene is regulating the function of a particular character. That means suppose when two or three genes are interacting among themselves to control the expression of a particular gene, then that type of outcome is known as the gene interaction. Okay, interaction between allelic or non-allelic genes of the same genotype in the production of particular phenotypic characters. That means when they are mutually affecting each other among themselves, then genes are, and they are affecting the phenotype or the genotype of the particular character. Okay. So this type of phenomenon is known as gene interactions. Okay. Now this is just the definition. Now moving on to the more detailing of this portion. Now why we are learning about gene interaction? This question is a common thing. This question may come into your mind. Why we will be reading about all these things? There may be more than two alleles for a given locus within the populations. That means we have already read that there are two types of alleles present for a particular character. The one is tall, one is short, one is wrinkled, one is smooth. We already discussed about all these things in in the Mendel's law. Okay. Now here what we will be doing, we will be dealing with the things something different from the Mendel's law. Okay, so interaction is taking place because there are two or more alleles for a particular population. The dominance of one allele over another may not be complete. That means when one dominance over another allele means, suppose in the Mendel's experiment, you can remember, if a tree is tall, then always the tall character is expressed, isn't it? And if a tree is short, then the short character is always not expressed. So the dominant character is more predominant. So if sometime it may occur that the dominance is the main, is not the main character controlling the whole thing. Okay. Now two or more genes may affect a single trait. Okay. The expression of a trait may be dependent on the interaction of two or more genes. That means when your character is being controlled by two or more genes, then that type of interactions is known as the gene interaction. Okay. Now, molecular basis of dominance, that means what is happening? Molecular basis, how your genes are getting regulated. A character is dominant if it is seen in the homozygous and heterozygous genotype, and is called recessive if it is observed in a single homozygous. That means if a particular type of a character is expressed in both the type of homozygous and homozygous heterozygous, this two term is a bit difficult for you. Same type of characters when expressed is known as homozygous, when different characters are expressed are known as heterozygous. So if these are the different type of characters being expressed in the different condition. The dominance of one allele over another allele is determined by the activity of protein products of allele, by the manner in which protein products of allele work is produced. This line is again difficult for you to understand. I will make you understand in simpler way. The dominance of one allele is another. That means dominance over one allele to another allele is mainly controlled by different type of protein products. Protein products. Students, again some network issues are there. Today we are facing too much problem in the network issues. Okay, now continuing with my lecture. We were talking about the molecular basis of dominance. That means how the different type of characters are being expressed in, and how they are, the molecular basis has been determined. Wild type allele are alleles that encode the phenotype most common in a particular natural population. It is often designated in genetic shorthand as PLAS. And mutant allele in any form allele other than the wild type allele. Okay. So what is happening? Wild type allele is the natural population which is present, and mutant allele means the character which is being changing, which has been changed to a different form is known as the mutant allele. Okay. So these two type of alleles are present in the molecular basis of the dominants. Okay. Now, this mutants, how this mutation is affecting us? Mutation disrupts normal gene function. Wild type allele, mutant allele can often be placed into either loss of function or gain of function category. That means what is happening here is that your mutation is disrupting the main function, and this mutant function can lead to either loss of function or gain of function. That means either your gene will lose the work it is doing, or it will gain more work what it is assigned to do. So okay, so these are the effects of mutation occurring in gene interactions. Okay, now types of gene interaction. What are the different types of gene interaction presence? One is allelic or non-epistatic, and one is allelic that is non-epistatic, and another is non-allelic that is epistatic. Okay. So, what is happening? Allelic means this type of interaction gives the classical ratio of 3:1 or 9:3:1. Okay. This ratio is known to you people. From where you have known this particular character? See, 3:1, you remember in the Mendel's law, we were reading about 3 tall and 1 dwarf. There we got the ratio 3:1. You might have remembered in the previous lectures I have told many times. So that the particular character which is expressing this type of ratio, maintaining this type of ratio, is known as allelic or non-epistatic type of interaction. Okay. Now, epistatic type of interaction, what is happening? In this type of interaction, genes located same or different chromosome interact with each other for their expression. Now, here the interaction is being taking place. Okay. What is happening? Your gene is getting interacted to another gene, and which is controlling the expressions. Okay. Discovery of non-allelic gene interactions has been made after Mendel, and can be best understood by studying phenotypic trait. See why Mendel? You have already known that Mendel has told all these things, 3:1, 9:3:1, all these things. But what happens? This non-allelic part is being discovered after Mendel's. Actually, all the things are not controlled by Mendel's law. Okay, Mendel's proposed some important aspects, but he has missed some points also, which is being illustrated by this gene interactions. Okay, now what is happening? Epistatic and hypostatic genes. That means you have to read about two types of genes, like epistatic and hypostatic. What is this genes? When a gene or locus which suppress or mask the phenotypic expression of another gene and or another locus, such gene is known as epistatic. Epistatic means when you are covering up somebody. Okay, when a gene is controlling the expression of another gene. Okay, when a gene is suppressing the function of another gene is known as, or masking. Mask means, you all know you are using mask nowadays. So mask means you are protecting your yourself from some virus, isn't it? So here the gene is masking the expression of another. That means it is covering up the expression of another gene. So it is known as epistatic. Okay, epistatic is a Greek term and meaning is standing up. Okay, so hypostatic means the gene or locus which is suppressed by a epistatic gene was called hypostatic. Suppose a particular gene is suppressing another gene. Now, the gene which is being suppressed, that means which is being suppressed by another gene, is known as hypostatic. Okay, these two terms are clear. Then we are moving on to the next thing, that is, what are the different type of classification of epistatic gene interaction? That means what are the different type of interactions which is occurring inside the cells? Okay, epistatic gene interaction is classified as follow in the basic manner, which
by which concerned genes influences the expression of each other. That means how these genes are regulating the different actions. Okay, so there are six types of epistatic gene interaction seen: supplementary gene actions, complementary gene action, inhibitory gene action. Now in this bracket the ratios are written. That means how these ratios are changing. You can remember in the Mendel's law, 9:3:1 is working, but you can see here the ratios has changed. 9:3:4 in complementary gene, 9:7. See, all these things are adding up to the same thing. 9:3:1 will give you 15, not 16. Okay, 3, 4, 3, 7, 16. Okay, you are adding in the ratios, you are adding, you are getting 16. See, here also you are getting 16 in each of the cases. That means the ratios are maintained in the same way, but the individual distribution has changed. See, inhibitory gene action, duplicate gene interactions, masking gene action, polymeric gene action. So there are six types of epistatic interaction observed in the genes. Okay, so in your syllabus mainly we are discussing about the first two variety, that is supplementary and complementary gene action. Okay, now coming to supplementary gene action, what is happening here? The ratio is 9:3:4 in the supplementary gene interaction. A dominant allele of one of two gene governing a character produces phenotypic effect. That means our allele is masking the effect of another allele. That means dominant allele of other gene does not produce a phenotypic effect on its own, but when it is present with Now we were discussing about the supplementary gene actions. In the supplementary gene action, what happens? The example is the agouti gray coat. That means a gray coat mice, where it has been seen that the one of the supplementary gene action means the dominant allele of two gene governing the character produces the phenotypic effect. Okay, so the other recessive characters are not expressed, so 9:3:4 ratio is observed. Okay, now coming to the next variety, this is the explanation of the supplementary gene action. See what is happening. Dominant allele C produces colored phenotype. That means capital C is responsible for the color of the mice. Okay, here we are doing the experiment with the mice color, mice coat color. Again, we are facing issues of network connection. Okay. Now we were explaining here the supplementary gene actions here. Now the supplementary gene actions were been explained in this slide. What is happening here? The C color, C, capital C is responsible for the production of your colored phenotype. Okay. So while dominant allele A produces no phenotype, albino, but when dominant allele A present with C, it produces agouti or gray phenotype. That means what is happening here is that your dominant allele, when A is present with capital C, it is producing gray color, but when it is alone is there, that means C is alone, it is producing albino color. That means no color is been seen. So here the ratio is 9:9 agouti, then 3 colored and 4 albino is being produced. 9:3:4. Okay, now coming to the next variety, that is complementary gene action. In this variety, what is happening? The complementary gene action, we are seeing the ratio as 9:7, and this experiment is being done by using sweet pea. Okay, sweet pea is being used to observe the experiment here. Now the sweet pea laryngeus odorators, flower per color is being chosen as the character. So here the white variety of color is used, and this white variety genotypic ratios is different, and when we are fusing this to white color, we are getting purple color. Okay, so
in the fertilization thing, it has been seen that there are 9 purples and 3 whites and 3 plus 3 plus 1, that means 6 and 7 white colored flower is produced. So 9 purple color flowers are produced and 7 your white color flowers are produced. So from this you can say that the particular gene action is being seen. Now, explaining this phenomenon, what is happening, see here, this purple color is crossed with the purple color, then in the next generation, we are also getting the same ratio, okay? So, 9 purple and 3 3 white and altogether 7 white is we are getting, okay? So, this phenomenon is known as complementary gene action, where the gene action is being suppressed. Here, see, this is a checker box where we are using each of the gene varieties and crossing each of the characters. Now, we can see that there are almost 9 varieties of purple are seen and 7 flowers are we are getting a white color, okay? So, now moving on to the next one, that is the incomplete dominance. With this, our lecture will end because this is the last topic of your gene interaction. What is happening in incomplete dominance? It is very important. Incomplete dominance, where dominance of an allele over other is not complete. That means when a particular type of character is not being fully expressed, we call it incomplete dominance. Incomplete means the thing is not getting completed. What is happening? The third phenotype appear, which are different from the parent phenotype but are closer to one homozygous phenomenon than the other. Okay, what is happening here? Suppose this is Mirabilis jalapa, that is a 4 o'clock plant. What is happening? See, in this diagram, you can see one flower is purple color, one is white color, and this one is a light purple color. So, what is happening? You may say that from where we are getting this light purple color? Light purple color, we are getting it from the mainly the incomplete dominance phenomenon. In this, what is happening? The purple color, that is the more dominant color, is not fully dominant. That means this cannot be expressed fully. So, the purple color is being seen, not the full white color or full purple color. Okay. So, see this diagram here. What is happening? You are fusing. I have said here purple, but here it is written red, no problem. You can consider it as red also, that means the colored portion mainly. The color, the red color is crossed with white color, then we are getting a pink color. That means not the red, not the white, none of them is expressed, but a new color, see a new phenotype, third phenotype is being expressed, which is intermediate of the two. That means red color is dominant over white color, but red color cannot be fully expressed. So the pink color has come forward. So if we cross it as a checker box, we can see that we are getting one red variety, two pink variety and white variety. So this phenomenon. Okay, we were talking about the incomplete dominance. We were discussing about how the particular type of flowers are expressing. Here at the third generation, we are getting the one red color, two pink color and white color. This is the phenomenon of incomplete dominance. Here what happens is that the red color is dominant over the white color and the red color is not fully expressed. So, an intermediate color like the pink color is being expressed here, and this phenomenon of not fully expression of the dominant gene is known as the your incomplete dominance. Okay, with this, the topic of gene interaction ends here. Okay.